Hello guys, this is Indian Medico, and in this video we are going to discuss about the history taking and examination of a case of varicose veins. Now this picture denotes the pathogenesis of varicose veins. In a normal vein, the wall will be functioning normally and there will be normal blood flow. Whereas in case of varicose veins, the wall will be deformed and it will lead to dilated vein and various other complications. Now let us see about the history taking for a case of varicose veins. Particulars of the patient should be taken in detail, like for any other case in general surgery. Special importance should be given to sex and occupation, because varicose veins are more common in females. Varicose veins affects females 10 times more than males, and it is more common in persons who stand a lot during their occupation, for example policemen. Now coming to chief complaints, the patient may complain of swelling along the veins, pain, pigmentation of skin or ulcer. You need to elicit the chief complaints and mention which leg is involved, whether right or left leg is involved, and you need to mention the duration, for how many months or years. A detailed history of swelling should be taken. Special importance should be given to relation of the swelling to standing or lying down. If there is any pain or color change in the swelling, which may indicate thrombophlebitis. Again, a detailed history of pain should be taken. The pain in case of varicose veins will usually be dull aching. It will involve the calves and lower legs. The pain will usually be more at the end of the day, and it will be relieved on lying down. When there is bursting type of pain, it indicates deep vein thrombosis. Pigmentation of skin history should be taken. A detailed history of ulcer should be taken. Other histories like itching and change in skin color should also be taken. Now coming to past history, any history of major ailment or deep vein thrombosis should be taken. If the patient had a past history of pain and swelling in calf associated with fever, it indicates deep vein thrombosis. Any history of prolonged immobilization or pregnancy should be taken, because these are risk factors for developing varicose veins. Now coming to personal history. History of smoking, alcoholism, and oral contraceptive pill use should be taken. Again, these are risk factors for varicose veins. Bowel and bladder habit history should be taken, because constipation is another risk factor for developing varicose veins. Family history, that is, if there are similar complaints in any other member of the family, should be taken. Treatment history should be taken. The patient could have been treated by an injection or elastic stockinate, or he might have been operated previously. Now coming to the examination of a case of varicose veins. General examination should be done like for any other case in general surgery. Coming to local examination, first you need to examine the diseased leg. Local examination should be first carried out in standing position, which will be followed by some special tests which are done in lying down position. Now these are the things that you need to examine in a case of varicose veins. Varicose veins per se, swollen legs with lipodermatosclerosis, any skin changes or any skin ulcers. All these should be examined properly. Now coming to inspection. Attitude of the limb should be examined. Any deformity should be examined. Local gigantism should be inspected. That is, you need to compare both the legs and see if the diseased leg is swollen. You need to inspect varicose veins. Varicose veins are usually dilated, elongated and tortuous veins. You need to inspect which venous system is involved, whether the great saphenous vein is involved or the short saphenous vein is involved. If the great saphenous vein is involved, you can see varicosities usually in the medial side of the leg. If the short saphenous vein is involved, you can see varicosities in the usually in the lateral side of the neck. You need to mention the extent of the varicose veins. That is, you need to mention varicose veins start from the dorsum of the foot up to where they go. For example, up to thigh. You need to mention, you need to inspect whether it is a localized or generalized swelling. If it is a generalized swelling, it indicates deep vein thrombosis. You need to inspect for cough impulse at saphenous opening. This is known as Morrissey's test. And you need to inspect for skin changes. The skin changes that you need to look for are local redness, which will be present in case of superficial thrombophlebitis. Pigmentation, you need to look for dark red or black spots. Eczema or dermatitis. Ulcer, you need to inspect the site, shape, size, edge, floor, discharge and surrounding area of the ulcer. You need to inspect for venous stars. Venous stars are nothing but a number of minute veins radiating from a single feeding vein. Other inspectory findings are stretched skin, loss of hair and brittleness of nail. Loss of hair and brittleness of nail indicate impending gangrene. Now let us see about the palpatory findings. You need to palpate for tenderness or thickening of veins. Other palpatory findings include thickening of skin, pitting edema, temperature. You need to palpate for temperature rise. You need to palpate for lipodermatosclerosis. Lipodermatosclerosis is nothing but progressive sclerosis of skin and subcutaneous tissue. We have already seen a picture of lipodermatosclerosis. And you need to palpate the ulcer. Now, venous ulcer is also known as stasis ulcer. It will usually be present in the lower one-third medial side of leg. It will have a well-defined margin usually. The floor will be the deep fascia usually. The ulcer will be associated with pigmentation, eczema and varicosity in the surrounding area. Now, there are certain special tests that you need to do in case of varicose veins. This picture depicts the principle of the test that you do. This picture shows the normal venous drainage. You have superficial venous system and deep venous system and perforator veins. This is the saphenofemoral junction. This is the normal venous drainage. Whereas in case of varicose veins, there will be venous hypertension. This venous hypertension can be due to saphenofemoral incompetence or it can be due to perforator vein incompetence. These can be tested by the following tests. Brody-Tendlenburg test. Now this test, the patient is asked to lie down. The veins are emptied by elevating and milking the veins. That is, the leg is elevated and the veins are milked. First, you need to find out the pubic tubercle. This is done by asking the patient to adduct the leg against resistance. You need to follow the taut adductor longus tendon to find out the pubic tubercle. Then you need to mark the saphenofemoral junction. The saphenofemoral junction is present 3.5 cm below and lateral to pubic tubercle. That is 3.5 cm below the pubic tubercle and 3.5 cm lateral to the pubic tubercle. Then you have to tie a tourniquet below the saphenofemoral junction. You can either tie a tourniquet or you can occlude the saphenofemoral junction with thumb. Now there are two Brody-Tendlenburg tests. In the first test, after the tourniquet is tied, the patient is asked to stand and the tourniquet is removed. That is, the pressure is released. If the varices fill quickly, the test one is said to be positive. It indicates saphenofemoral incompetence. In the second test, after the tourniquet is tied, the pressure is not released. That is, the tourniquet is not released. And the patient's leg is observed for 2 to 3 minutes. If the varices fill, the test is positive. It indicates perforator incompetence below the saphenofemoral junction. Now, how do you test for other perforator incompetence? Before you test for other perforator incompetence, you need to know what are the other perforators present in the lower limb. Dodd's perforator is present above the knee, that is in the inferior one third of thigh. Boyd's perforator is present just below the knee. Cockett's or medial ankle perforators are 3 in number. They are present 5 cm, 10 cm and 15 cm above the median malleolus. Now each perforator should be tested individually. The test for perforator incompetence is called 2 tourniquet test. This, the patient is asked to lie down, you empty the veins and you tie one tourniquet above the perforator and one tourniquet below the perforator. Then the patient is asked to stand. If you find varicosity of veins, it indicates the perforator is incompetent. This test is done for all the perforators individually. The next test is Schwartz test. In this, the patient is asked to stand. One finger is kept at the saphenous opening and you tap the dilated vein lower down in the leg. If you feel a impulse in the finger kept at the saphenous opening, the test is said to be positive. This test is positive in gross varicosities of veins. The next test is modified Perth's test. This is done for testing the patency of deep veins. This is done in standing position. A tourniquet is tied below the saphenous opening when the veins are full. The patient is then asked to walk for 3 to 5 minutes. If the superficial veins become more distended and if the patient complains of bursting pain, the test is said to be positive. A positive test indicates occluded deep venous system. Other possibility is that the dilated superficial veins will collapse. This indicates that the test is negative. If the test is negative, it means that the deep veins are patent. The next test is Fagan's test. In this, the course of the great saphenous vein is marked, especially the blowouts are marked. The patient is asked to lie down and the veins are empty. Then you need to palpate in the area of blowouts, that is in the area of communicating veins. If you palpate, you can find out crescentric gaps in the deep fascia. This is another test done in varicose veins. Now, the next test that you'll do for a case of varicose veins is Morris's cough impulse test. In this, the patient is asked to lie down and the veins are emptied. After this, the patient is asked to cough forcibly. If you can feel an expansive impulse at the saphenofemoral junction, it indicates saphenofemoral incompetence. Now, there are certain tests for deep vein thrombosis. They are Homan sign and Moses sign. These are present in acute deep vein thrombosis and these are not done nowadays because the thrombus can get dislodged on doing these tests. After palpation and doing the special test, you need to auscultate the varicose veins. If you hear a bruit, it indicates the presence of an arteriovenous fistula. After this, you need to examine the other limb, regional nodes. You need to measure the limb circumference of both the limbs. You need to measure limb circumference at a point above or below a fixed bony point and you need to compare both the limbs. Then you need to examine the arterial pulsations. Once you are done with ST taking and examination, you need to present the diagnosis. While presenting diagnosis, you need to mention that this is a case of varicose veins. You need to mention which limb is affected, either the right or the left lower limb. You need to mention which system of veins is affected, either the great saphenous system or the short saphenous system or both the systems. Then you need to mention the perforators that are incompetent. Say for example, the saphenofemoral junction is incompetent and the 5 cm ankle perforator is incompetent.
etc. You also need to mention if there are any clinical evidence of deep vein thrombosis or not. If you have any suggestions, please let me know in the comment section. If you like this video, please like, share, subscribe, and tell your friends about this channel. Thank you.